Today we have the very inspiring famous personality Abhishek Mishra, also known as the Iron Man, who left his corporate job to get into endurance sports with us. So today we are here to know about your journey. So I'd like to start by asking the most obvious question. What, according to you, is the best way to stay healthy?
I think having a self-discipline and a focused life where you can control, you know, your senses, which is mostly eating, because 80% of the time when you're not healthy or you're not fit is because of your eating habits. So I say that, you know, your fitness or your health regime starts with your mental awareness. So if you're mentally aware, you want to be healthy and you make it your priority, your choices are according to that, you know. So I think mental fitness is something which starts, you know, with the initial step of being healthy and being fit.
So what do you support? I mean, running, or do you support any other?
It's about living an active and a healthy lifestyle, you know. So being active means could be anything. You don't need to be a runner to be active or healthy, okay? You don't use lifts, you know, use stairs, you know. Walk 1 or 2 kilometers if you have to go to a market, you know. And then parallelly maintain your eating habits. So it's not necessarily running a marathon or a half marathon to be healthy. You know, being healthy means your BMI is good, your body weight, you know, is good as per the age and the height, you know, and the entire body structure. Then being fit is different thing, you know. You can go to a gym to raise your fitness level. It depends what is your intention. You want to be an endurance person, you want to be a bulky guy, you know. Basis that, their fitness level can vary. But being healthy means they can balance their entire day-to-day life, you know. You're not feeling lazy early morning when you have to get up. You're not feeling tired when you're working for 12 hours, 13 hours. So that balanced life is healthy, and then fitness has levels which you can increase day by day.
Alright, so since when are you into running and how has it helped you over the years?
So my first run was in 2011 when I did Little Delhi Half Marathon. Now it's been 7 years I'm running. So I started with half marathon, I did full marathon, then I did ultra runs, you know, I did 24 hour runs, I did 161 in the Kutch Desert, then I started doing triathlons and all. How it helped me was, that's where I'm into running or in endurance sports. Endurance sports changes your behavior, you know. And it's a proven fact that when you do something, you know, where you're physically active, your body generates hormones and endorphins, which keeps your stress level balanced, which will keep your temper down. You'll not have any ego. So what happens when you run and you cross a physical barrier? Because suppose if you have never thought of that, you'll run right now 400 meter in the stadium. Once you do that, that sense of achievement which comes changes you to a different human being. Your ego will go down. You'll not have any self-centric behavior. Then that's where you'll feel that, okay, you're very ground to earth. You'll start feeling about society. You'll start feeling about people who are next to you. I think that was the incentive or motivation which kept me going. That behavioral change which I was noticing within myself.
Okay, so we know the Ironman race is 180 kilometers of cycling, 42 kilometers of running and 3.8 kilometers swimming, all within 17 hours.
Right.
Yeah? So you're into long distance running. So how do you think, I mean, are there times when you feel tired or you feel like, oh, I mean, I can't do it anymore? And, you know, are there times that you've gone through all this?
So, every day.
I mean, for a person who hasn't run this much, I mean, obviously, these are the obvious questions that one can ask you.
Right.
So, I mean, yeah.
You know, there's a very known ultra runner in the world. I think he's one of the top 10 ultra runners in the world. Somebody asked the same question to him, that do you feel tired when you go out to run? He said, every day, every 5 kilometers. And I feel the same. I think every runner feels the same. All these runners who are running there, initial half an hour, they feel, kya kar raha hun? Let's go and sleep. You know, these winters, those lehavs and blankets are much better than coming out,
yeah.
You know. But that's the initial feeling, you know, and that happens. So I'll tell you, when I started training for Ironman, I was never a swimmer in my life. You know, I registered for Ironman, which was in September. I started learning swimming in the month of April. So in 5 months, I had to learn and swim in the ocean water, that 3.8 kilometer, and then cycle and then run, right? So, you know, that endurance sports is tiring. Somewhere you feel that, why am I doing it? Am I crazy? I felt that in my first Ironman while cycling, because I was never a cyclist or a swimmer, you know. So that feeling comes in your mind. But then, as I said yesterday, that be somebody, not anybody. That somebody means, when I read about Ironman, there were hardly 10 people who had got the title in India. Imagine, 130 crore people and only 10-15 having the title. So that was motivating me, that I'll be among those 10-15 people, you know, that niche crowd. It's a different feeling which gives you, where you feel proud. It's like when you're there in the United States, you meet some Indians, you feel proud because you're among few Indians who are there in US, right? So the same was there when I was there doing Ironman and all. And then once you feel that, so like when I did my first half marathon, I had a sense of achievement. That kept me going for my full marathon, you know, then my ultra runs. And that ultra run achievement kept me going for Ironman. And no one can define it. What you get, people ask me, okay, you got the Ironman title, I said, yeah. He said, how much money have you earned? I said, nothing, it's just the title. They said, okay, it's only the title. I said, yeah. They said, then what? Yeah, bekar hai. But they won't understand. It's like asking a smoker, why do you smoke? They don't know. They cannot tell you the feeling. It's like that. And it's meditation for me, you know. When I do it and I know that, okay, you know what, I have 17 hours to finish. And this happens with me in my first Ironman. When they come and they asked me, they said, okay, you stop, you're out of the race. But still, when I realize that, okay, I'm doing it for myself, and if I keep going this way, then I think it will take me somewhere, you know, that the changes which I was noticing within myself.
Okay, so now that you have achieved the title,
yep.
So what are the ways one can work towards achieving the title? I mean, of course, you have something to share. Probably, you know, you can just start up by saying you should run this much. And for somebody who hasn't run at all.
Right.
I mean, of course, Ironman is a big title. But for somebody who hasn't run at all in their lives, what advice would you give? And also, what are the ways one can work towards achieving the title?
See, it's about starting someday, and it's about starting. So there's a word which I say that, you know, you need to be clear with your intention to know the intensity. So I cannot run like Usain Bolt. His intention is to get medals in Olympic. I started doing it for myself. This is my own journey. You know, I'm exploring myself. So my intensity was, you know, go easy, go slow, keep getting endurance and keep doing it. So I took 7 years to reach here. Somebody who wants to do it now, within 2-3 months, have to train accordingly. So now the training for every individual depends on their intention of what they want to do. Somebody wants to be a 400 meter sprinter, somebody wants to do a marathon, somebody wants to do an Ironman. Basis that, you know, their training will vary. But they have to start from a place, and they need to understand their entire body structure and regime. Don't go and read somewhere that, okay, you know what, oh, I saw this video, this guy runs bloody this much, trains 6 hours, but then he takes rest accordingly. If you are working, you cannot do the same thing, right? There has to be, so that's where the entire training thing, you know, differs. So I'll say start slowly, listen to your body, understand what is there which is required, and then keep progressing. And then there are lots of people to train and, you know, and help and suggest basis that.
So what is your fitness regime and, of course, your eating habits?
So fitness regime vary basis on my training plan, okay? So like now I'm training for Ultraman. There are only 2 Indians who have done Ultraman so far. So Ultraman is 10 kilometers of swimming, 422 cycling, and then 84 kilometers of running. And you have to finish everything in 36 hours. So for that, my training is different. Like I'm focusing more on swimming, then cycling, then running. Because running, I know I'm good at. I'm running from past 7 years now. Then cycling is my second. And running is, swimming is my worst. Being winters, when you have to swim in Florida, it's being, you know, it's only 2 months left. I have to put more focus. So my training is I swim 3 or 4 days in a month. Then I cycle 2 days and I run once in a week right now. And every 10 days I try to do something maximum. You know, so like I'm planning that in January I'll do a 10 kilometer swim, 145 cycling, then next day 280 cycling, then third day 84 running, which is the Ultraman. So I'll try to do it 20 days before so that I know where I stand. So basis that my training varies. Eating habit, I eat everything cooked at home. So what, instead of avoiding food, I have avoided the procedure. So I don't eat wheat flour, which is maida. I don't eat refined sugar. I eat jaggery and honey instead of that. And I don't eat fried. That's it.
Thank you so much, Abhishek. Believe me, you've inspired someone who hates running.
Yeah, if I inspired you, I think we'll run now 400 meters and see.
Definitely, definitely. Sure. Thank you so much for
thank
your time,
thank
Abhishek.
Thank you, thank you.
Thanks for listening to Radio Dwarka. For more updates, keep on listening to Radio Dwarka, A Step Towards Tomorrow.